Are you looking to up your real estate investing game? Well, you're in the right place. Welcome to the Sub2 Deals Show with your host, Sub2 expert William Tingle.
Hey, Sub2ers. My name's William Tingle of Sub2Deals.com. I would like to welcome you to this episode of the Sub2 Deals Show. We're coming to you live today from the Beauregard House in the French Quarter, New Orleans. So the format's going to be just a little bit different, but hopefully we'll share some information that will help you with your business. I want to talk to you guys today about ethics and how you run your business. You know, I saw a post recently in another one of the creative finance forums on Facebook, where the topic was using false names and even fake business names when VAs do, I guess, the initial call to people about selling their houses. And my question on that was, is that how you really want to run your business? I mean, are you a drug dealer or are you a real estate investor? You know, we hear people talk about these things from time to time, using burner phones for bandit sign numbers. That way, if code enforcement calls you, you can just throw that phone away, get a new one, print new bandit signs and do that sort of thing. And I think if you're reaching out to sellers and you want to, you know, this is really a long game. If you want to be in this business for years, if you want to be known as the house guy or the house girl in your location, then you want to do things just a little bit differently, maybe a lot differently. I mean, I understand that we're in a society today where people like to sue. And, you know, there are all kind of new laws being brought on the books every single day regarding texting, regarding cold calling and that sort of thing. But seriously, I mean, if somebody has got a house for sale and you reach out to them, first of all, you're not going to have any problems with that. Now, I understand people that blanket zip codes or area codes or states or counties, and they just call people at random. Hey, have you thought about selling your house? Well, that could get you into some trouble. But even most of those laws allow for one call. Now, there, you know, you can interpret that differently if you want to. You can say, no, that's not the case. They can get you on the first call. Maybe they can. I don't know. If that's that big a problem, maybe you need to look at some different marketing methods, seriously. But, and I really would, before I would consider instructing my VA to tell anyone that my name's Bob Smith, because it's just not, you know, my name's what it is. You guys in my coaching group that have listened to me do cold calling, you know that, listen, I tell them who I am. And if they ask, which the majority of sellers won't, but I'll give them the business name that we're working under. So, you know, if it's Plan B Properties, then that's what we are. If it's another business entity that we're working with at that time, then that's what we'll tell them. Depends on what our exit strategy is, what we're trying to do. So my advice to you, like I said, it's a long game. And I think that you really want your name out there. You want to be known for what you do. And I understand that people today, it's different than it was 10, 15, 20 years ago. You know, people buy all over the country. You know, when I got started investing, I instructed my students, don't buy more than an hour away from where you live. You want to be able to drive out, see the house, do things. And then when I left the country, when I started buying houses remotely, you know, I had to do things a little bit differently, but that didn't mean that my name changed when I was calling sellers. You know, they still knew who I was. That's still how we operated. I've had an occasional seller ask to see a copy of a driver's license or something, especially buyers when you're dealing remotely. They want to know who you are. But where does it stop, really? If you can't be who you are in your business, then maybe you just need to rethink things. I don't know. But I think it's a bad idea to do that. And I know there's some other teachers out there that'll differ with me. And listen, that thread was pretty interesting. It was really interesting how many people just really dogpiled the initial poster saying, hey, you know, you never give your real name. You never give the VAs the name that, you know, your actual name. They always should use something because certain sellers, you get somebody that's mad, that wants to sue, and they'll come out and file a lawsuit against you and do all this sort of thing. But I'll tell you, I've been doing this for 22 years. I've never had that happen to me. If I get on the phone with somebody that's angry or agitated or doesn't want to talk to me, I'm going to be as polite as I can. I'm going to excuse myself from that phone call, and they're going to go on a list and they'll never, ever be called again. And if you're using a CRM, and we recommend REI Black Book, that's the one that we use. You can go in there, you can note those people as someone that doesn't need to be called again. In fact, we have a list, a call flow workflow that we've actually titled, "Don't call them back, they'll kill us." So we take that pretty seriously too. And I think Kevin at REI Black Book told me recently that they've implemented a system where when you enter someone that doesn't need to be called, it actually goes into their system and it'll flag it for everybody. So that's a good thing. But as far as using your actual name, your actual company name, when you call sellers, when they ask those questions, I think that's really the way that you need to run your business. Of course, that's just me. You do you. And, hopefully we'll all still buy some houses and make a good living. Like I said, we're on location here. We're outside in our courtyard in New Orleans. You can hear some of the sounds here right now. That's, I guess, a policeman or a fire truck. So there you go. Anyway, hope you guys are having a great day. Hope you're talking to some sellers and buying some houses. Hey, if you haven't signed up yet for our Sub2Palooza, which is actually why we're in New Orleans right now, we're getting ready for that event. That's going to be on September the 9th and the 10th of this year. We're going to have some great speakers. We're going to have some of the most respected names in real estate. They're going to have a really great bunch of people out here. We're tired of Zoom meetings. We want to meet and actually talk to people, have a drink or something with somebody, talk about some real estate. So if you haven't signed up yet, you can go to sub2palooza.com, get your tickets. They're in regular bird pricing right now. It's the best price you'll get. So get out there, get some tickets, meet us down here in New Orleans. So in the meantime, get out there, talk to some sellers, and you will buy some houses.
Thanks so much for listening to this episode of the Sub2Deals Show with William Tingle. If you enjoyed today's episode, please leave a review and subscribe. And for more great content and to stay up to date, visit sub2deals.com and on Facebook at Sub2Deals. We'll catch you next time.